Hello. So, I am going to try my Remy's Remy Smaller Five Supply Challenge. And I'm going to use this Arteza book, just like my Remy. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and follow. I think she may have the bigger book, I'm not sure, but I'm going to go with this is one I have. What I'm going to do is I'm going to link her video below, so go check out what I'm talking about if you don't already know. You can probably do, but check that out. And then she has a link underneath her video for Arteza where you can buy these books, and it's an affiliate link, so she will get a little bit of money for that. So these are nice little books, so I do like them. So I'll just get to a random page. So she used, one of her supplies is her paper, and she used a stencil to draw around some things on her paper that she liked. So what I'm going to do, I don't have a stencil, so I'm just looking around and see what I have. That's quite big. I'm sure I've done this before I turn the video on, probably. But this. Thinking that bird is going to be quite a nice image. So that I'm going to draw around with my pencil. I don't even want to do many circles of mine. I have some small circles here. Excuse me. very dirty cups. Well, how about getting some of these stamps in? So this is a graphic 45 paper. Botanica Bella collection. This page is Birds in Paradise. So I like that. Something a bit larger. Oh dear. Give me a minute to find some circles. I'm just gonna have to tip this little pot out. A bling pot, right. Yes. And then inside this. More of the smaller ones, just for some colour. Okay, and then go away, cut those out, and I'll be back. My circle cut. Now I have to decide where I want them. see, where did I put my clips? I had some clips. Oh, they're on my other book here. Okay, so I'm just going to hold the pages down a little. Okay, so let's grab some glue. I'm going to use Elm's glue, I think. You should wash your hands between projects. I'm just so eager to film for you guys. Okay. It's very thick paper, so you need good glue for this. It's good quality scrapbooking paper. So, do I want this over here? There we are. So that's that. And now we're just going to grab the clear gesso. And give the whole page a good coat of clear gesso. And I have the Liquitex clear gesso. Do we have a good brush? Let's see. This one will do. I think I'll get this one. Squirt some gesso on. Give this page a good coat. side. Wire is driving me a little bit mad. I'll try and see if I can find my other battery in a minute and try and figure out if it's the fault of the battery or this cable. Although it seems to be running the computer camera fine, so I don't see why it shouldn't be charging. It must be the battery itself. Okay. Let that dry, and I'll be back with the next supply. Okay, so now we're ready to add our woodies. So, I'll pick these three colours because they go with what's in the imagery, I think. Orange might be a little bright, but we'll see. Having the colour. Yeah, it's a little bright. So, what I may do is just grab this blue light. And this wire is driving me nuts. You can see it as well. Sorry. Maybe I can just turn it down a touch. Voilà. Just something very, very rough. It's giving us a bit of texture, so we're going to add orange again here. That's some water. And blend it out with the baby oil. So yeah, the gesso is helping it move. I can see here, I might have missed getting right into that circle because that wood is not moving much. So we'll just blend around if we can. There we go. Lovely. Then let's add some of the brown. Water going to blend it all down. Okay. Just keep going. I feel like my video is lacking the lovely cute background noises of little Hannah. of her little chit chats in the background of Maremi's videos. I keep calling her Maremi, it's not Maremi. Marta. Because her channel name is Maremi. Mm-hmm. I love it. Okay, so if we go a little bit brown on this side, perhaps a little green up here now. I'm going to be very careful with the screen because it's very bright. So I'm hoping that it will blend nicely with the brown to sort of neutralize it just a little bit. Green over here to balance that green up there. It's not going to play well. Okay, now do we go orange, brown? Yeah, I think we need a little bit more orange. So when you're doing this, remember it doesn't have to be the same supplies as Marta, just 5 supplies. I just so happen to have woodies, so I can use them. I could have used my Inktense stencils or watercolours or whatever I had or wanted to use, but I haven't used my woodies for a very long time, so I thought yes, perfect. You can use gelatos if you have gelatos. I haven't used those for ages either. I think page in a little. Not the best brush. Let's try this one. Okay. Oh, this cable, honest goodness. Oh, I'm gonna get frustrated in a minute. I'm not sure about that, so I'm going to add some more of this brown. Just tone it down a little bit. More vintage-y feel. Let's let that dry and come back with the next step. Okay, so give my gesso a bit of a stir. I think it's going a little bit bad maybe, but that's okay. It'll be fine. So can you do what do as Marta does, stick my finger in it. I need to use this spatula, get some of my finger, and then we're just gonna soften that colour down. It will move because it's water soluble. Mm-hmm. So this is just toning down all those colours, smoothing out any areas that aren't blended nicely. That's gonna look lovely. We're gonna have that colour there still, but it's gonna be nice and gentle. It's gonna help with the blending. Now I'm about to use the black Woody with hers, but I don't think I'm going to. I want the paste to stay nice and light, I think. There we go. So, I'm liking that. It's nice and soft now. So we'll let that dry. We'll dry it off, by the way. And then come back with whatever's next. So now we have our pen, our uniball pen, and we're just going to roughly go around the circles. I have this stencil that I can use for I'll try this one. I don't actually look that even. That's okay, I can make it look messy anyway. Yes. Okay. And then the white gel pen. Is this the right one? Creamy white. Yes, I think so. Yes, this is the one that works. Scribbly border. Oh, it's a bit wet there. There we go. And then I need to find a nice quote. Okay, so print this off my label maker. Cutting it very wonky. Let's see. Promise of spring's arrival is enough to get anyone. The bitter winter. Let's do that then. I'll get thirsty again now. I just feel like it's an appropriate quote for the fact that it's been snowing pretty much all day. I'm not looking forward to going out there in the morning. I'm very much looking forward to some spring. Although I suppose it might help with the current climate to keep people indoors where they should be. Maybe I should slice this up a little smaller. It just looks a bit odd being so long to get anyone. Okay, and then we outline with the block. To bring it in with the rest of the page. And then we're going to do some splashes, pop a date on, and we're done. Nice to try something a little different every now and then. It's not the sort of page I would normally do, but I've enjoyed it. It looks good. It's splashes, so let's grab a woody. Do we do black or brown? Let's do black. Black woody. Water. And I need a brush that's going to splash well. Let's just try this one. Oh, that cable's creeped around again. Okay. So. I knew that was going to happen. And then maybe lot some so that it matches this. There we go. And then we'll date it. I'm just gonna date it with my pen. Let me see. Touch. Oh, stops the baby right. Let's just tidy up a tad. The date is the 14th, is that right? Let me just go back. Yeah, 14th. Pop the date here, 14th of the 1st, 21. There we go, let's try and clear the desk a little so we can have a peek. There we go. So Moemi's 5 supply challenge. There we go. Not exactly the same as she did it, but that's the idea, isn't it? Take inspiration. I did it basically how she did it, but that different. So, I hope you enjoyed that video. We'll leave a link to Moremi's original video in the description, so please pop along, have a look, join in the fun, and as I say, you can buy the book from her affiliate link. So thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed it. Stay home, stay safe, and I'll catch you again soon. Bye bye.